Let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life, in our chance, Allah's name do we sing. Allah, 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 Ya Allah.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي اما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. I want to welcome you to a new episode of Only If You Knew. We'll continue talking about Allah's beautiful name Al-Afew. Allahumma innak afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu anna jami'an ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma innak afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu anna ya Allah. Have you forgotten other people, those who you've wronged? Try to remember those who you have wronged to seek their forgiveness. And if you have anyone who wronged you, then please forgive them and have that heart and live with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name Al-Afu. Remember that weight that you might have been having on your heart, on your shoulders, that is stopping you from moving forward in your future. If you still didn't forgive, if you're still not willing to forgive, then please pay attention to the following events that we're going to talk about. That events that I can swear by Allah is a lot tougher than the things that you went through. Na'am, na'am, whatever you went through, whatever it may be, what you will hear now is a lot tougher. I would like to first, before we continue, would like to welcome our dear guests. If you can please mention your name.
My name is Adis, and I'm from Bosnia.
Beautiful.
I'm Asmir, and I'm from Bosnia too.
Great.
I'm Hamdi, I'm from Bosnia.
Great.
I'm Ray, I'm from Indonesia.
Barakallah fikum. Barakallah Ray, Hamdi, Asmir, and Aris. Alhamdulillah. So we all know you by now, and I hope the brothers and sisters, we feel that bond, subhanAllah, even though it might be miles away, but the La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah is just a beautiful bond. We ask Allah to never let go of us. Yeah. May Allah subhanAllah never let go of us, because if Allah left us for 1 second, we've lost. SubhanAllah. Allahumma la takilni ila nafsi tarfata ayn. Oh Allah, don't make me depend on myself, not even for a blink of an eye. To that extent, we're so weak, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the love between us to be maintained, inshaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ عَفَى, this is a verse from the Quran, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. If you forgive and reconcile, then your reward is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, what's the reward? Don't worry about it. Al-Afu, one more time as a review, Al-Afu is the one who erases your sins and there's no traces of it. You forget that you've done the sin. The angels forget that you've done the sin. And the book is erased and it doesn't say that. You go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah doesn't even mention that sin that you've done. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ you go to Jannah. Al-Afu, but then he becomes pleased by you, and that's one of the sweetest part of it. And then he gives you blessings, and blessings which we just mentioned is Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, which Al-Albani weakens, and some ulama say it's Hassan. So it depends which would you like, and you look into it and leave it to the ulama. So some say Hassan, some say Daif. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا وَقَفَ الْعِبَادُ نَادَ مُنَادَ. On Yawm al-Qiyam, when everybody is standing, and everyone is standing, and you remember the fear, remember that when the baby's hair that is black or yellow or brown turns to be white. On that day, a caller will call. Nada munad. Man kana ajruhu ala Allah falyadkhul al-jannah. Whomever the rewards in Allah, let them go to Jannah. Then a big group stands up and they go to Jannah. Without hisab. Then another time. Man kana ajruhu ala Allah falyadkhul al-jannah. Whomever the rewards in Allah, then let them go to Jannah. There are people see, who's the people standing up and leaving? Third time, man kana ajruhu ala Allah, then let them go to Jannah. Then they stand up a group, then they go. Then they asked, man hum al-adlina ajruhum ala Allah? Who are those people? Three words. Al-afuna anil nas. So, i'fu, not just because Allah to forgive you, i'fu to go to Jannah. Ala tool, without adab wala hisab. You see the difference of al-afu is a lot higher level. Look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how he forgave people. A Jewish lady, first of all, not Muslim. Yes. Second of all, a Yahudi who is an enemy, kafir muharib. She invites him and she gives him some food. And then as he is about to eat the meat, what happens? Jibreel alayhi salam comes immediately to Rasulullah. Stop eating. Why? Because this shah is masmuma, poisoned. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks to the lady. He said, why did you do this? Why did he make it poisoned? She said, what? لِأَقْتُلَكَ, to kill you. She said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not allow you to kill me. The sahaba, they all said, Ya Rasulullah, دَعْنَا نَقْطَعْ عُنُقَهَا. Ya Rasulullah, may us cut her head. And no one will go against this, صح? Even the Yahud will agree. You know what? She deserved it. She tried to kill a person. What did the Prophet ﷺ say? La. No. A kafir muharib. She tried to kill him. And she's a Yahudiya. And he said, oh, forgive him. Rasulullah ﷺ. Did someone try to kill you? Did someone try to poison your food? Forgive. I'll give you more examples. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. At the beginning, those الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالدَّرَّاءِ. So those who give money, and those that are كَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ and الْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. That's the levels. الْعَافِينَ is the toughest part. Ya Allah, what about them, Ya Allah? وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah called them muhsinin, the highest rank. Remember the first episode about introduction? Islam, Iman, Ihsan, Na'am. Ihsan is the highest level. That's the level of those who make du'afu. But those also have to avoid major sins, because the muhsin never does major sins. You gotta pay attention. I don't wanna go into another tangent, but the muhsinin don't do major sins. The muslimin, they probably do. Mu'minun don't do major sins. Al-muhsinun don't do major sins. Maybe minor here and there, but they ask Allah to forgive them. Al-afiyah al-nas is that level. If you wanna jump to that level, forgive people. Forgive people, Allah will love you. And we already said, if Allah loves an act, then do it, even if it might not make sense to you. Look at Uthman bin Affan. He raises his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, Allahumma, inni qad afawtu in kuntu zulimt. O Allah, I pardon anyone, whoever wronged me. Anyone. And then he says, faghfir li in kuntu zulamt. And O Allah, forgive me if I ever wronged someone. You see the heart which he had? Look at Imam Abu Hanifa. Imam Abu Hanifa, wallahi, that incident, unbelievable. Imam Abu Hanifa has about 86,000 fatwas. How big of an alim he is, if not even more than that number. He was so respected in his environment, in his local city. A man comes to him and he talks to him about his mother. He said, Ummak, such and such. He cursed Imam Abu Hanifa's mother. What does Imam Abu Hanifa say? The wise man, the knowledgeable man, what does he say? He says, Allah knows. My mom is not like what you said. He said, your mom is this, she does this, this is haram, and so on. He said, Allah knows, my mom is not like what you said. The ignorant man got so angry. He said, ya fasiq, ya zindiq. He called him kafir, basically. You're outside Islam. What did Imam Abu Hanifa do? Go kill this munafiq. He called me a kafir. Because whenever you call a person a kafir, then one of you have to be a kafir. Man kaffara musliman fa huwa kafir. It's a very, very serious issue. What does that mean? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what hadith did Abu Hanifa know? What names of Allah did he know that changed him? You know what he said? He raised his hand. He said, ya Allah, in kuntu kama yaqul, if I was like what he said, then please forgive me. And if I wasn't like what he said, faghfir lah. Forgive him, ya Allah. Unbelievable, wallahi. Subhanallah, a hadith and stories is just unbelievable. You know why some people don't forgive? Sometimes the problem is not big. No, it's not big. It's because of disease in the heart. Because of some arrogance or pride that they don't want to be embarrassed in front of people. Look at, for example, Abu Talib. Rasulullah ﷺ said, say la ilaha illallah. Say something, just one thing, that I can go talk to Allah about it. Something that I can have to present to Allah. That he said, la ilaha illallah. Ya Allah, make me intercede, do shafa'a to him. Abu Talib, what did he tell him? Abu Talib said, لَوْلَا أَن تُعَيِّرَنِي قُرَيْشٌ لَأَقْرَرْتُ بِهَا عَيْنَكَ. If it wasn't that Quraysh will say, because now he was almost sick, he was to die. He said, if it wasn't that Quraysh will say, oh, he's about to die. That's when he said, la ilaha illallah. If they're not going to say this, I was going to say it for you. And it will make you happy. Because this shows in his heart, he truly believes in it. But he doesn't want to say it. He doesn't want to declare it. But he will die as a kafir. Just people don't say bad things about me. So sometimes it's a disease in the heart. And sometimes the disease in the heart is worse than other things that are physical. Because one disease in the heart can be worse than watching something haram. Why? Because, for example, kibr. An atom weight of kibr in your heart, what will happen? You will not go to Jannah. What's the proof?
There is the hadith from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he said that whoever from the kibr, he can't go to the Jannah.
Exactly. لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. You see how dangerous that is? Sometimes what doesn't people make him forgive is because shaitan. Shaitan whispers to you because he knows if you forgive, if you go to Allah al-Afu, you're going to go to a level that's beyond what he wants you to go. Shaitan, does he want you to go to Jahannam?
No.
Shaitan wants you to go to Jahannam? Shaitan, he wants you to go to Jahannam? No, he wants to go to the bottom of Jahannam. He doesn't want to only go to Jahannam. He wants to go all the way to the bottom with the munafiqeen. If he can't, then the second level. If he can, then the lesser one, and so on. He will do his best. He has so many traps, 7 levels, tries to push away. So he tries to whisper, don't forgive. Why? Because if you forgive them, they might do it again. So don't forgive them. The shaitan says, oh, don't forgive them because then people will make fun of you. Don't forgive them. They don't deserve it. They don't deserve for you to forgive them. And if you forgive them, you know what will happen? Everyone else will think, you know what, then I will do it to them, then they will surely forgive me. You say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. You ignore shaitan and you look at people, for example, like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq has an incident that, wallah al-azim, I don't know any human being in our time that has the iman of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu said that if the iman, authentic hadith by Umar. Umar said radiallahu anhu, if the iman of Abu Bakr is in one kaffa, and the iman of the ummah is in one kaffa, the iman of Abu Bakr would rajah and be heavier than the whole ummah. What did he go through? What is it that he witnessed? Inshallah, I will tell you right after the short break, inshallah. So please be patient. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chance, Allah's name do we sing.
It's the essence of Islam, Tawheed. Believing in the oneness of Allah, the same message that Allah sent all His prophets with since the beginning of time.
La ilaha illallah. You need Tawheed. Especially at the time of distress, at the time of need.
Tawheed first with Imam Kareem Abu Zayd in Ramadan only on Huda TV.
So let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chance, Allah's name do we sing.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Huh? Did you forgive? Did you go through some names, like 5 names or 6 or 7? You said, I'll forgive this, I'll forgive that one. Khalas, I will live with Allah al-Afu. I'll afu another person. But that one? Never. Are you still rigid, ya akhi? Ukhti, what's wrong with you? Bismillah, forgive. Let me tell you this story, inshallah, so you can belittle your problem that you went through. And maybe it's something similar. Allah knows best. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu anhu, who his daughter is who? Aisha, radiallahu anha. What happened? Aisha, radiallahu anha, she was also the wife of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aisha has been accused that she committed a major sin, wal-iyadu billah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has freed her from above 7 heavens in Surah An-Nur, that she's innocent, and punished those who have accused Aisha, radiallahu anha. A man by the name of Mistah bin Athatha, who is the cousin of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, or a relative to him, he joined the group of those who are spreading the fitna and the rumor that Aisha did so and so with that other man in the desert, wal-iyadu billah. Well, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was so angry. What would you do if someone says that about your sister or mother? SubhanAllah, something beyond our imagination. Some people will say, I will go and kill him. I won't even think twice. I will go do this to him. You know what Abu Bakr as-Siddiq did? He said, wallahi, I will never, ever give him his monthly allowance. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq used to give him monthly allowance. And Mistah, his cousin, continued to talk about Aisha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a verse because of this. A verse just for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and those that are in the same umbrella. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ. Don't let those with fadl and sa'ah, those with money, don't withhold it. Don't keep it to yourself. Don't stop. Don't stop what, ya Allah? Don't stop giving it. To whom? أَن يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Don't stop giving them the money. So Allah is ordering Abu Bakr to what? To give the money back to his relative. That's how important the ties of kinship are. Ya Allah, he talked about my own daughter, ya Allah. He talked about the wife of Rasulullah. Allah doesn't only tell him to give him the money back. Allah tells him to give the money back and وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا and forgive them. Ya Allah. Unbelievable. Then Allah says, subhanAllah, now I ask that question to all of you and to all who's watching. Allah says in the same verse, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you love for Allah to forgive you? Then Allah says, Wallahu ghafurun rahim. When this verse was revealed, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, Bala, Bala, I would love for Allah to forgive me. Bala, Wallahi, I will never ever stop giving the monthly allowance to Mistah. Allahu Akbar. What kind of afu, what kind of forgiveness is this? What kind of response to Allah? Allah revealed the verse, Bismillah, go ahead. So Allah revealed the verse to all of us. Are we going to apply? Let's do our best. Let's follow those role models, those with hearts, subhanAllah, with full of iman. May Allah make us like them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the king of all those who forgave, the Sayyid, the master of all those who forgive. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's a janazah. Who is that person that is in the janazah? Who died? Abdullah bin Ubay bin Salul. Ra's al-munafiqeen. The head of al-munafiqeen. Quick background. Allah says Surah Al-Baqarah, after the Surah Al-Fatiha, second chapter number 2, He mentions al-mu'minun, sah, or al-mu'mineen, in a few verses. Then 2 verses about al-kuffar, then 13 verses about who? The munafiqeen. For how dangerous they are, how bad they are, how horrible they are. Allah said also in Surah Al-Nisa, if I'm not mistaken, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. The lowest part in Jahannam is who? The munafiqeen. With this being said, Abdullah bin Ubay is not only a munafiq. He is the ra's al-munafiqeen. What did he do? I'll mention some events. Number one, things that Umar Khattab reminded the Prophet about. What does Umar have to do with it? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is about to pray janazah on Abdullah bin Ubay bin Salul. Sometimes our own brothers and sisters, a person would die, a Muslim, and they refuse to go to the janazah. Do you want to even call them when they're sick? And the Prophet is going to pray janazah and lead janazah on Abdullah bin Ubay. And he's a munafiq, not just that. When Umar Khattab saw this, he came to the Prophet. He stood in front of him. He said, Rasulullah, what are you doing, Rasulullah? It's Abdullah bin Ubay. You pray on a munafiq, Ya Rasulullah, the ra's of the munafiqeen. Rasulullah sallam, the whole time was smiling. He said, Ya Rasulullah, what are you doing, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Da'ani, let me do what I'm doing. He said, Ya Rasulullah, then he continued to remind him of what Abdullah bin Ubay did. He said, do you remember Battle of Uhud, Ya Rasulullah? Battle of Uhud, we were 1,000 against the Kuffar 3,000. And we already so low in numbers compared to them. And then he went back to Medina with 300 people. Remember what happened to the hearts of some of the believers? They went down and some of them had dispute because of him. Ya Rasulullah, remember when we were going back to Medina many years after. And he said, لَيُخْرِجَنَّ الْأَعَزُّ مِنْهَا الْأَذَلِ. The one with honor will kick out the one with is humiliated. Who said that? Ubay. Saying that he has honor and the Prophet is the one who is mazlul. You remember that, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Rasulullah, remember who is the one who spread the rumor about your wife, Aisha? It was Abdullah that began this. It was Abdullah bin Ubay that began this. Ya Rasulullah, don't you remember? The whole time the Prophet was smiling. He said, أفرغت. Are you done? And Khattab was surprised. He said, let me pray. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, let me read it for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, let me just read it. أخر عني ثم صلى عليه وسلم فقام حتى فرغ. Okay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed 2 verses. So I just want to make sure, because when it comes to the Quran, you know what? Embarrass yourself in front of the whole world, but don't embarrass yourself in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm serious. Go and apologize for 1,000 people for taking a delay and so on. But when it comes to the Quran and the Hadith, pay attention, Bismillah, and go with it. Is that clear? Yes. Because you want to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah tells you, you had the verse in front of you, and you chose to save your pride, to look cool in front of people, and make a mistake in the Quran that you revealed. No, Bismillah, let's go with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Rasulullah sallam, and the Prophet was saying, that if you were to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them, or not to forgive them, Allah will never forgive them. And if you ask Allah over 70 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive them. Over 70 times. The Prophet said, if I knew, if I were to ask Allah more than 70 times to forgive Abdullah bin Ubay, I would have done it. Then he prayed janazah. Umar al-Khattab could not imagine this. Then he left. After this, Allah revealed the verse. He says, وَلَا تُصَلِّ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ مَاتَ أَبَدًا وَلَا تَقُمْ عَلَىٰ قَبْرِهِ. After that, Allah revealed, don't do that again, Ya Rasulullah. Oh Rasulullah, don't do that again. He's a munafiq. You don't pray munafiqeen. But the point of this, with the heart was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the man who slandered his own wife, the man who slandered him through every way in his honor and dignity and so on, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he still continued to forgive. Did you have problems or do you have problems bigger than those? Are you still rigid? I hope not. I hope not. So what's the action item? If you know someone who you have a problem with, go and talk to them. And wallah, I like to share, you know what, sometimes it might be difficult to forgive and forget and so on, But I tried this, and wallahi, it was a blessing. SubhanAllah, the heart felt so beautiful. One time there was a person who owed, for example, our family some money. Then no one in the family was talking to that person. And no one in the family was mentioning by first name, rather they would call him by a horrible name. Learning about Allah Al-Afu in the family, reading about Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala's beautiful names, I said, you know what, I want to call him and I would like to say that I forgive him for whatever share we might have out from this. I would like to forgive him for whatever happened. But I know if people know that I called him, I'm going to get jumped and beaten up by my own family. So I go by like a calling card, go outside the house, call him, say, Assalamu Alaikum. He said, Wa Alaikum Assalam. He said, who's this? I'm like, Majid. He's like, what do you want? I'm like, I just want to tell you that I forgive you. He said, are you serious? I said, wallah, I forgive you. I hope there's nothing between our hearts. And that man was about to cry over the phone. He could not believe that someone actually did forgive him. And wallah, you don't understand. You know who was happier? Not him. I was the one who was happier. That the heart felt at rest, that I have no hate towards my brother. And we ask Allah, sometimes we fail. Sometimes we'll tell you it's very difficult to forgive others. But may Allah give us the heart to forgive everyone that is around us. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu, this is one incident. We ask Allah to may have this as a habit in our life. You know, for example, I know it's on TV. You know they say, Hakuna Matata. They just forgive. Just forgive and forget. Call a person and make a joke out of it. Call them. If you're a young person, you know what I'm talking about. Tell them, you know what, Hakuna Matata. Forget everything that happened. Then they laugh and you laugh together and you smile and tell them, you know what, let's forgive the past. Let's forget the past. Let's not look into this anymore. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you for your shortcomings bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you forgive other people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who have patience. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who have that soft heart, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always accept our dua. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna ya Allah. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. Barakallahu feekum. Thank you very much for joining. Jazakumullah khair for your patience. And inshallah we'll go with the next episode and we'll conclude with Allah's beautiful names. And what is it? It's one of my favorite. We'll mention inshallah next episode. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So let's make up our minds to do the right thing in this life. In our chants, Allah's name do we sing. Allah, 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 Ya Allah. When we step out of our homes in the middle of the day, do we ever think when's the end of my stay? Someone dies in the news right in front of your face. Do we ever think when's my turn in the grave? To read all the tales of the kings of the past, do we ever think how long did it last? Day after day, night after night, do we ever think?